For this video, I'll be looking at the life of Lois Weber, one of the greatest directors of her time and one of the first female directors. Given the amazing turnout at the Women's March earlier this year, I want to look at Lois Weber and her contributions to not only all women, but to all other filmmakers who succeeded her in the industry. I'll be making this video alongside a very special guest who will give her take on Lois Weber's place in the entertainment industry. As always, the links to the show's social media pages will be in the description. Also, share these videos with people you know. It's always good to learn a little history. Enjoy. Lois Weber's career began at a very interesting time. Motion pictures were in their infancy, a new century had just begun, as well as a new age of ideas and imaginations. Growing up with Victorian-era values, Lois Weber was sort of the bridge between the old generation and her own. Getting her start in the early 1900s with her husband Philip Smalley, Weber wanted to put her own ideals and philosophies into her films. Her focus on social justice films and experimenting with the split-screen technique has given her the distinction by many as being the first true auteur director. She has often been cited as being on the level of D.W. Griffith, but I think that Lois Weber was in a class of her own. While Griffith went with grandeur, and in the case of Birth of a Nation, historical inaccuracies and extreme racism, Lois Weber wanted to highlight the struggles of what was truly going on in the real world. She was someone who can be seen as being one of the first true feminists in American society. She was once quoted as saying,
"I like to direct because I believe a woman, more or less intuitively, brings out many of the emotions that are rarely expressed on the screen. I may miss of what some of the men get, but I will get other effects that they never thought of."
Ironically though, she actually distanced herself from the women's suffrage movement. It's not clear exactly why, considering her films showed strong women, and more often than not, independent women. Take her 1913 film, Suspense, as an example. In this 10-minute film, Weber plays the part of a new mother who, when her servant quits and walks out the door, attracts the attention of a stranger who tries to seize the opportunity of robbing and possibly raping a woman who is unguarded. While she's on the phone with her husband, she notices the man trying to break into her home, and her husband rushes back to save her and their newborn child. While the husband does make it to the house in time, the scenario is much different from what had been shown up to that point. While Lois Weber introduces new concepts to film, she was also among the first to attract censorship groups who wanted purely wholesome entertainment. At a time when religion dominated the social conscience, it was easy for criminal charges to be brought onto someone if enough public outrage called for it. Still though, Lois Weber was only beginning to use the full effect of what movies could do. This occurs in her 1915 film, Hypocrites, which in my opinion is one of her most powerful films, as it truly shows how she considered film to be an art form rather than simply cheap entertainment. The film shows a Christian theme at first by showing a monk trying to complete a statue of truth before his death at the hands of a mob when it's shown to be the image of a naked woman. However, as the film progresses, we're shown the physical manifestation of the naked truth, as a ghostly image of a naked woman, played by actress Margaret Edwards, appears. She shows the hypocrisy of those who killed the monk by exposing them as being greedy, lusting for power and sex. The image of a naked woman was done through the use of a double exposure, for which Weber successfully experimented with. Her film caused an uproar with the public, and was even delayed from being released for many months. When the film was finally released across the country, it was banned in Ohio and started riots in New York. Worst of all, though, was in Boston, where the mayor demanded that the film negatives be painted over to show the nude woman with clothing, which completely causes the film to lose its symbolic meaning. The Blot, released in 1921, perfectly shows the independence of a woman taking charge to support her family. Actress Claire Windsor plays Amelia Griggs, who works as a librarian to provide for her family who are struggling. What's extremely notable about this film is that Lois Weber used real settings with non-professional actors to capture what it's truly like to live in poverty. While censorship groups again didn't like this film, the critics surprisingly defended it, and is now considered a classic today. To get a better sense on Lois Weber's role in not only cinema history, but in shaping how women became more than what was expected of them, I would like to turn this over to my guest, women and media student Margaret Selesnev.
back when I was interested in exploring film as a major, I was told straight off the back that if I wanted to be a director, it would be extremely hard for me to find a job since there's such a small percentage of female directors out there. And that's done on purpose. Hearing that was really discouraging since I was told I was at a real disadvantage just because I was a female. So learning that Lois Weber fought against society's regulations back then, it is really inspiring for me as a woman. It's interesting to see how her generation was battling against the norms set by the patriarchy. They were shining a light on how women were able to work in these industries just as well as the men had before. Weber was not afraid to go against the men who were controlling censorship rules in order to get her significant messages across to the audience. It's really refreshing to see a feminist such as Lois Weber using her medium to gain awareness of the unfair treatment and inequality women experience on a daily basis.
Lois Weber created a strong foundation for future filmmakers to build on in terms of pushing the boundaries of what is considered acceptable content in today's media. She may not have realized it, but she was giving women a voice they didn't have before, especially for women like Frances Marion, who would go on to become one of the most successful screenwriters of all time, winning 2 Academy Awards for her screenplays The Big House, released in 1931, and The Champ, released in 1932. Lois Weber's career came to an end in 1934, following the release of her first talkie, White Heat. While the film was both a critical and commercial success, it was only released to a limited number of theaters. As with many from the Silent Age, the coming of sound signaled the end of many careers, and even Lois Weber wasn't immune. Nevertheless, her work is still remembered by film historians as being some of the first of its kind. With her approach to a new medium, she truly made something that was seen by many to be a novelty into art. For Margaret and Joe, I'm Big Rob, and I'll see you again soon.